Sadly, in the realm of spirituality, what does the word miracle mean?
Anything that cannot happen in a predetermined and mechanical way. Love is a miracle. Consciousness is a miracle. Understanding is a miracle. Logic and thought cannot explain these things, so they are miracles. That which cannot be the result of any process is a miracle. That which cannot be the result of an algorithm or manufactured in a factory is a miracle. That whose origins are not only unknown but actually unknowable is a miracle. A camera is not a miracle.
Acharya, I have always felt that, especially to the elders at home, that when I have a lot of love to them, unconditional, then there is no need of respect. But all the society wants respect. I do always do that. But I feel that even if a little bit, but I have been forcing myself to do that. When I feel that there is no need, I will anyways satisfy all their desires and all the needs just out of love. Then why is it that we always need respect all over? Not just in family, everywhere.
The word respect, as is commonly used, denotes power. Respect in its truest sense means understanding. But the way it is commonly used, respect means power. When you respect someone, then you would stand up for him or do this or do that. You would give him obedience and such things. So respect has a very gross meaning in the popular sense. That is not the real meaning of respect. The root word is seeing. I suppose the root word is specure. You'll have to check up the etymology. I suppose it is specure. It is also the root from where spectacular, inspection, spectacles and such words come. So at the root is seeing. Seeing. When you see and again see and understand, that is respect. Respect has nothing to do with obedience or compliance or all the stuff that the word has in its orbit. What's the root and how is it pronounced? Check the etymology. Our structures are based on violence. They have power hierarchies. And those power hierarchies demand the kind of respect as is commonly understood. Show respect to your boss, show respect to your grandparents. All that is a result of the violence contained in the structure of relationships. In those relationships, love does not suffice. If you love your grandfather, that is not sufficient. You must also respect grandfather. And there is a distinction drawn between love and respect. Similarly, loving God is not sufficient. You must also respect God.
Yeah, why is that?
Because our minds are exploitative and violent. And so the structures emerging from those minds are also violent. They want to keep the other down. because they have an egoistic need to keep themselves up.
So is that why a violent mind has to be told to surrender to God, whereas the person who is there loves God?
Loves God.
He will not say they have to surrender or submit. The submission has to be made by a person who...
Because you anyway surrender to 1,000 people. That is why it is said that you must surrender to God. Instead of surrendering to all these people, you better bow down to God.
What does it mean to surrender to ego? Surrender to your ego.
Surrender your ego.
Your.
Love is the highest respect to yourself.
Love is the only respect, not the highest respect. You don't have grades of respect. Love is respect. What else? How can you love without seeing? If you are loving without seeing, then what are you loving? Love really is not blind. Love must see.
Is it possible to, is it feasible, is it even something to say that I love not that person, but what that person has the potential to become?
Potentiality of everybody is the same. Our greatest potential is one. But that doesn't matter.
Don't some people manage to suppress that potential more than others?
But then you're talking of potential, not the expression of the potential, right? The potentiality is the same. You have Kabir. Sab ghat mera saiya suni sej na koi. The potential is there everywhere. Har ghat mera saiya suni sej na koi. Within each ghat, within each body is the same Lord. Nobody is barren or bereft of Godhood. But then he qualifies his first statement in the second line. He says, Balihari va ghat ki jaghat pargat hoy. All of us have the same potential. But I submit myself to the one in which the potential has gained expression. Balihari va ghat ki jaghat Paragat hoye. Potentiality, at the level of potentiality, everybody is the same. People differ in terms of their level of expression. Whether you have chosen to give expression to your soul or not. There are some who decide that they must live by their heart, that their lives will be expressions of their heartful song. And there are some who decide that, you know, a lukewarm life will suffice. So, then there is a difference. What is this? Sure, sure. Let me first go into that word now that it has come to my mind. Where is the? Acha, it is. How is it pronounced?
It's spesere.
Spesere. That's the root. Spesere. Look at. Seeing. Spesere means look at. So, respect is then the root spesere. So, re-spesere means re-look at. Re-look at. That is respect. I'm not sure that it's pronounced as spesere or what, but is it spesere?
Krishna?
At the surface, obviously there are distinctions.
But the way he says that all are void, but Buddha is passive, Jesus is sad, Krishna is
That's
active.
His poetry. That's his poetry. What you see on the surface is always the personality. And the personalities are obviously going to be different. The personality of a Buddha and the personality of Jesus and the personality of Krishna and that of Muhammad are never going to match. Personalities are a product of time, age, eras, conditions.
But But he ends up branding Buddha as incomplete, that he attained the ultimate
after death. And all the expressions are incomplete. The very fact that truth has taken the form of a human being means that the human being is going to be incomplete. His heart would have completeness. The form is bound to be incomplete. It doesn't matter what the name of that form is. Not only is the Buddha incomplete, everybody is incomplete. Everybody is incomplete. Yes, some can be taken as relatively more complete. That's okay. Only the formless Brahma is complete. Only the formless one is complete. The moment there is a form, the moment there is manifestation, how can the manifestation be complete? At the heart of the manifestation lies completeness. At the heart of the manifestation lies completeness. But not in the form and the personality of the manifestation. There you would obviously see incompleteness here and there. There is no need to make a big issue of that.
Also, Acharyaji, what do you say about people having suicidal thoughts?
They love themselves.
Is that what you would say to someone who came to you and admitted that they had these thoughts?
I'll tell him. It's because you love yourself, so you don't want to go through all the suffering. It's not that you want to kill yourself. You're just throwing a flying kiss at yourself by committing suicide. You love yourself. And if you love yourself, then aren't there better ways to express your love? Even the tendency to commit suicide is a proof of self-love. Is it not? You love yourself so much that you can't tolerate the rut you are in. So you say, not live rather than live this way. And if you love yourself, then why not give a constructive expression to your love? Suicide is a very feeble and a very sick expression of sick love, of self-love.
Acharyaji, I've been to a few ashrams in the past during my spiritual quest or journey, and people who were living there. So, since long I was listening that you need to leave everything once you are fully into that path, and because the society or marriage and that creates a bondage, so you fully devote to that. But I have seen and heard that people go mad even they are not balanced. And the yin-yang energy, that, and few concepts like our saints, like Kabir, they all are in Krishna Ashrama, so this is an escape, and you should get married, or otherwise, I heard, even at times doctors say that you create a lot of disease and different kind of things, so there is a confusion between. I don't have any confusion regarding that once you are devoted to that truth, there is nothing is priority, and if you... like the whole family, kids and all that, drag your attention to something else.
See, it's simple. If really truth is your priority, then you won't even feel like talking about something else. And if truth is not yet your priority, then don't pretend that truth is your priority. Then go and serve your priorities. If truth is really your priority, then it is truth, truth and truth. And you are playing and dancing. The world is your stage. Dance. But if truth is not yet your priority, and you are just professing. See, the fellow is having fun with the tea. That's more blissful to watch than this answer. If truth is not yet your priority and you still decide to emulate the saints, then it is blind suppression. And unexpressed and undissolved desires will keep troubling you. Either come to a point where you see the stupidity of desires, or go ahead and fulfill your desires. No point pretending that you don't have desires. Either dissolve them or fulfill them. Either work hard to dissolve them, or if you find that you don't want to dissolve them, then go ahead, fulfill them and bear the consequences.
Well, it might be a path that we are just taking one step at a time. So we are not even pretending and not out of desires, just somewhere in between. Looking at
you are nowhere in between. You are where you are. Now at this point, if truth is your priority, then truth is your priority. And if something else is your priority, and you have decided that something else will remain the way it is, then go ahead with it.
Actually, I'm dealing with some health issues, and the doctors were saying that that creates surgery or imbalance. I don't know, actually. So I just want to know, because I don't
know. The body is having problems, the doctor know what to do with it. The body is having certain problems, let the doctors decide. As long as it is not psychosomatic, which most of the problems are.
Mm-hmm.
The doctors are?
Suggesting marriage as a solution. That is
the problem. Go ahead. You see, if the fulfillment of the body is important, and they are saying, I mean, how is marriage related to? They mean sex, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. They mean giving birth.
They mean giving birth. Not neither, neither sex nor marriage.
Giving birth.
They mean giving birth. So give birth. Why are you marrying?
And then you will give sex.
If that is the equation, why are you complicating it?
It will be very easy. I promise you.
You are taking such a long route. You will marry. You will carry a man.
You will think how to leave your child alone.
No, and giving birth is a one-time affair. Right? But to give birth once, you will then have 1,000 episodes of sex. Not only before birth, but also after birth. What is this? It's like, you know, you need one matchstick and you buy the entire shop.